Good morning, dear students. So today we are going to start with the grammar topic pronoun cases, right? So let's do it. Personal pronoun cases. So first of all, I hope you very well know what are personal pronouns. How many types of personal pronouns are, I mean, how many types of persons are there? Sorry. How many types of persons are there? Yes, Manshika.
Three types. First person and third person.
But I have asked only one student and you are answering me collaboratively. That is not good. First person, second person, third person. So what is first person? Yes, Janvi Dhingra.
The speaker.
Jo I se related hai jitni cheeze. I, me, we, us. That is first person. Okay, Krishi, what is second person?
Mam, yours.
Yes, jo you se related hai. Related to you, you, your, etc. Those are covered in second person means the listener. Usko hum kehte hain second person. Okay? And third person. Third person, Gurjas.
Ma'am, the person who we talk about.
Yes, the person that we talk about. That means we can say he, she, him, her, they, them, it. These come under third person. So before going to the towards the personal pronoun cases, we must be clear about first person, second person, and third person. And beta ji, now we'll discuss subjective or nominative case and objective case. There are two cases of personal pronouns. First is subjective case, second is objective case. Subjective ko hum nominative bhi kehte hain, the part of the sentence which acts as a subject. ठीक है जो सब्जेक्ट की तरह काम करता है उसको हम सब्जेक्टिव केस कहते हैं मींस बिफोर द वर्ब द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ द वर्ब जो ऐसा आ जाएगा हमारे पास पर्सनल प्रोनाउन दैट विल बी नोन एज एट द सब्जेक्टिव प्लेस एंड दैट इज आफ्टर द वर्ब वर्ब के बाद आएगा पर्सनल प्रोनाउन दैट विल बी नोन एज ऑब्जेक्टिव केस जैसे मैं आपको एग्जाम्पल देती हूँ लेट मी गिव यू एन एग्जाम्पल ही गेव मी अ पेन So he is at subjective place, me is at objective place. So the positions and their manner gets changed. And how do they get changed? That we'll see through this chart. Okay, if I talk about first person singular. So at subjective place, it is I, but at objective place, it becomes me. And I know you know all these things. आपको ये सारी चीजें पता हैं. कोई भी नई चीज नहीं है इसमें. You know and you use the same things. In voice also, when we change the positions of subject and object, so how do they change? You know that I becomes me, we becomes us, you remains you, he becomes him, she becomes her, they becomes them, and it remains it. And in the same way, I have just made a chart here. If I talk about first person singular, then it is I at subjective place and me at objective place. First person plural, that is we. We is at subjective place and us is at objective place. If I talk about second person that is related to you, it remains you. Whether it is singular or it is plural, whether it is at subjective case or objective case, in all the cases it remains you. If I talk about third person male singular, male ki baat karu to it is he, but at objective place it becomes him. And in the same way, female at subjective place it is she. But at objective place it is her. But if I talk about third person, that consists things and animals. Things and animals ke liye we use it, but it remains it in the objective place also. And if I talk about third person plural, plural for male, plural for female, plural for things, plural for animals, it is they, and it becomes them at objective place. Now these are possessive adjectives. Why I have, and these are possessive pronouns, why I have written both the things? Because you get confused in these. आपको पता नहीं चलता, sometimes आप my, our, your, his, her को भी possessive pronoun में ले लेते हो, but these are possessive adjectives because these are followed by a noun. So there is a very simple identification. The word which is followed by a noun will be adjective. So this is my, our, your, his, her, it's, there are पोजेसिव एडजेक्टिव्स, बस सी पोजेसिव प्रोनाउंस, देखिए जरा ये माइन आर्स योर्स हिज हर्स देयर्स, सो एवरी वर्ड इज एंडिंग विद एस एक्सेप्ट माइन, माइन के अलावा हर एक के पीछे एस लगा है एंड इन द 99.9% केसेस दे कम एट द एंड. फॉर एग्जाम्पल दिस हाउस इज देयर्स, दैट पेन इज माइन, तो ये सेंटेंस के एंड में आते हैं. So there is very simple identification and recognition of both the things, possessive adjective as well as possessive pronoun. And now these are reflexive as well as emphasizing pronouns. Myself, ourselves, yourself, yourselves, himself, herself, itself and themselves. So आपको पता है what are reflexive and what are emphasizing pronouns. If we are left with the time, we'll surely discuss it once again. हम इसको दोबारा से discuss जरूर करेंगे. Now see examples. She called him. Now she is subject, called is verb and him is object. So मैंने जैसे आपको पहले कहा verb से पहले is at subject, is known to be at subjective place and after the verb it's known to be as objective place. तो ये जो him है that is at objective place and ये जो she है that is at subjective place. So you will remember this thing. He laughed at me. In the same way he is subject, laughed is verb and object is me. Okay? So in this way we'll do subjective and objective cases and we'll see where to put subjective case and where to put objective case. So there are some rules. Iske kuch rules hain, hum wo ek bari revise karenge ki what are the rules. And again this is not a new topic for you beta ji. You know where to use subjective case and where to use objective case. Now if I talk about between, jahan between aa jaye, with between objective case is used. Okay, with between objective case is used. See example, between you and me, between him and me, between them and us, between Hari and me. Sorry. So देखिए बेटा यहाँ me, him, us, them. These all are the pronouns that are used at objective place. हमने पीछे ये जो चार्ट किया है यहाँ एक बार नजर मारिए, जितने भी मैंने वर्ड्स लिखे हैं आई हैव यूज्ड ओनली दीज वर्ड्स, मी, अस, यू, हिम, देम एक्सेट्रा. सो दैट इज वाई जब बिटवीन आ जाए, जब हम किसी के साथ बिटवीन की बात करते हैं, दो पर्सन के लिए बिटवीन यूज होता है, सो विद बिटवीन वी ऑलवेज यूज ऑब्जेक्टिव केस. ठीक है, बिटवीन हिम एंड मी ही इज द थीफ. Between me and you, you are a liar. In this way, so these are the examples where between, between के साथ objective case use होता है. Now let's see the next rule. Next is with complement of be verb. Now what is be verb? Who will tell me what is be verb? Hurry up, hurry up. Again, Vanshika, Krish, you tell me what is be verb. हम बी वर्ब्स उन्हीं को कहते हैं, इज़ आर वाज वर बीन एक्सेट्रा. सो इनके साथ वी ऑलवेज यूज सब्जेक्टिव केस. कौन सा केस यूज करना है? सब्जेक्टिव केस, जो हमने चार्ट की पहले कॉलम में देखा था. नाउ लेट सी सम एग्जांपल्स. सो दीज आर बी वर्ब्स, इज एम आर वाज वर एंड बीन. सो इफ समवन आस्क्स यू हु इज देयर, यू गिव आंसर इट इज मी. हम ऐसे ही आंसर देते ना, इट इज मी, बट दैट इज द इनफॉर्मल लैंग्वेज. आई मीन when we talk about a language of communication, when it is in talking terms, then we can say me. But when it comes to writing, that means it is formal, then the right answer is I. Your answer should be it is I. It is me is a wrong notation when it comes to writing. हम writing में कभी भी objective case use नहीं करते हैं. Objective case is used only in case of colloquial language. Colloquial means जो आम बोल चाल की भाषा होती है. जो आम बोलचाल की भाषा है कॉलिक्यू लैंग्वेज ओनली देन वी कैन यूज मी अदरवाइज द राइट आंसर इज आई मींस वी आर टू यूज सब्जेक्टिव केस विद बी वर्ब्स अब इज आ गया तो हमें सब्जेक्टिव केस यूज करना है नेक्स्ट एग्जांपल इट वाज ही नॉट हिम इट वाज दे नॉट देम हु डिड दिस अब चाहे वाज है चाहे इज है चाहे एम है वर है We are to use only subjective case. Is it clear to everyone? If I were he, not him. अगर मैं उसकी जगह होता, if I were he, इसका मतलब है अगर मैं उसकी जगह होता, I would not do it. मैंने ऐसा नहीं किया होता. Okay? हाँ जी बेटा जी, just tell me, are these two rules clear to you? Just show me thumbs up. It is clear. If it is clear, just show me thumbs up. If these two rules are clear. ओके अभी मैंने आपको सिर्फ एक बिटवीन बताया है और अभी एक कॉम्प्लीमेंट ऑफ बी वर्ब इसको हम कॉम्प्लीमेंट बोलते हैं बेटा बी वर्ब के बाद हमेशा कॉम्प्लीमेंट्स आते हैं दीज आर नॉट ऑब्जेक्ट्स ओके नाउ सी द नेक्स्ट रूल स्टॉप टॉकिंग तन्वी सो आफ्टर द कंजंक्शन देन जहां देन कंजंक्शन आ जाए देयर ऑल्सो वी यूज सब्जेक्टिव केस वहां भी हमने सब्जेक्टिव केस ही यूज करना है एंड यू नो इट वेरी वेल यू हैव बीन डूइंग दिस फ्रॉम योर फिफ्थ स्टैंडर्ड नाउ दे आर रिचर देन अस सो अगेन दिस इज इनफॉर्मल थिंग आई मीन दिस इज यूज जस्ट इन कॉलिक्यूल लैंग्वेज वी कैन नॉट यूज इट इन आर राइटिंग व्हेन इट कम्स टू राइटिंग आवर आंसर शुड बी दे आर रिचर देन वी और इसके लिए आपको क्या करना है अपने माइंड में उसके साथ हेल्पिंग वर्ब लगा के देख लेनी है इफ इट इज मेकिंग अ सेंस दैट मींस आवर सेंटेंस इज करेक्ट सो दिस इज द फॉर्मल वे टू यूज देन हु इज टॉकिंग ओके सो नेक्स्ट एग्जांपल इज You are wiser than her is wrong thing. I mean, we cannot say it is totally wrong. This is just informal thing. हम इसको पर अपने while using grammar, while doing grammar, we cannot use this thing. Our answer should be you are wiser than she is. Means वही है अपने mind में helping verb लगा के देखिए. It is making a correct sense. That means it is right. Now the next rule. The next rule is, in case of let, जब हम let का use करते हैं, objective case is used. With let, objective case is used. But let is a verb. Let is a verb and after verb, we always use objective case of pronoun. For example, let me go out. Let us go for a walk. But if we say let we go for a walk, that is a wrong notation. The right answer is let us go for a walk. I hope this topic is clear to you. There are only four rules. Char rules hai beta. Let or between ke saath objective case aana hai. Be verb or conjunction than ke saath subjective case aana hai. Only this much you need to remember. Let and between ke saath bache objective case. Be verbs and conjunction than ke saath subjective case. Yes, dear students, so next is relative pronouns that we are going to discuss in our pronouns topic. So relative pronouns, again, you have done it many a times. So relative pronouns are the pronouns which are used to join two sentences. Hum sabko pata hai, relative pronoun hum tab use karte hain when we need to join two sentences. So the relative pronouns are which, whose, who, whom, that. Which, whose, who, whom, that, these are the relative pronouns. And out of these relative pronouns, which and that means the first and the last one are used for non-living things or animals. Sirf inko hi hum non-living things or animals ke saath use karte hain. Rest of the relative pronouns are used with living things. These are used for living things. But sometimes you commit mistake. आपने किसी person की बात करनी होती है तो आप which use करने लग जाते हो. किसी animal की बात करनी होती है तो आप who use करने लग जाते हो. So that is the wrong thing. Only this thing we need to remember. Okay? Now, for example, the girl is standing in the corner. She is my friend. So these are two different sentences, but we are to join these two sentences with the help of a relative pronoun. So that is, the girl who is standing in the corner is my friend. So for living thing, girl is a person. Girl is a living thing. I have used who. तो इसके साथ who use करेंगे, which use नहीं करेंगे. Now next, let's see next example. I have a dog. It is white in color. So the answer is, I have a dog which is white in color, yeah, that is white in color, one and the same thing. So you can use both the relative pronouns in place of each other. Yeah, which use कर लो या that use कर लो, it hardly matters. So this is animal. तो animal के लिए मैंने which या that use किया है. I cannot use who. So these things you need to take care of. So the there are some things which you need to know, that is antecedent of a relative pronoun. And I know you know about antecedent. Who will tell me what is an antecedent and how to use it? Where is it placed? Yes, Vamika.
Ma'am, the noun to which a relative pronoun refers.
Anji, so where relative. Is it placed? Antecedent kahan rakha jata hai?
It is placed before the relative pronoun.
Yes, it is placed before the relative pronoun, means ye dono ikatthe hi aane chahiye. Like boy and who, they should be in partnership, means they both are siblings. Jo ek hi ghar mein rehte hain. Sometimes what mistake you commit, aapka relative pronoun kahin aur ghoom raha hota hai aur antecedent kahin aur ghoom raha hota hai, means you separate both of them. आप उनको सेपरेट कर देते हो एंड दे, हाँ जी, सो आप इनको अलग कर देते हो, यू सेपरेट देम, तो क्या होता है कि दे स्टार्ट लिविंग इन सेपरेट हाउसेस, दैट इज नॉट एक्सेप्टेबल. आपके भाई बहन है, आप सब एक घर में रहते हो, तो ऐसे ही एंटीसिडेंट और रिलेटिव प्रोनाउन को एक ही साथ रहना है. ओके, एंटीसिडेंट और रिलेटिव प्रोनाउन को आपने हमेशा इकट्ठा रखना है. This is the prime most condition of forming a relative pronoun, a sentence with the help of relative pronoun. अगर आपका antecedent और वो अलग अलग हो गए, तो समझ लेना कि आपका जो sentence आपने बनाया है, that is wrong. So this is the first most condition. Okay, now see next. So common mistakes while joining the sentences with relative pronouns. So use of relative pronouns with wrong noun. आप क्या करते हो, किसी wrong noun के साथ अपना relative pronoun use कर लेते हो. See, this is a very good example. The old woman lives in a hut. I know her. आप क्या करते हो? The old woman lives in a hut. Whom I know. तो आपने relative pronoun किसके साथ लगाया? Hut के साथ. तो यहाँ whom जो है वो hut को refer कर रहा है. Here it means that you know the hut. You don't know the old woman, but you know the hut. So is it possible कि आप किसी की झोपड़ी को जानो, बल्कि उसमें रहने वाले इंसान को नहीं जानो? So, आपका जो नाउन है वो क्या होना चाहिए, विच इज बींग रेफर्ड हियर. वट शुड बी द नाउन इन दिस सेंटेंस विच यू वॉन्ट टू रेफर टू? क्या होना चाहिए वंशिका?
ओल्ड वुमेन.
ओल्ड वुमेन. द राइट आंसर इज, आई नो द ओल्ड वुमेन हु लिव्स इन अ हट. सो हेयर जो हु है, दैट इज रेफरिंग टू दिस ओल्ड वुमेन एंड दिस इज द राइट सेंटेंस. सो ये जरूरी नहीं है कि यू विल बिगिन द आंसर फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट पार्ट ओनली. यू कैन शफल बोथ द पार्ट्स. जैसे मैंने यहां से शुरू किया, आई नो द ओल्ड वुमेन हु लिव्स इन अ हट. सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट मिस्टेक दैट यू कमिट व्हाइल जॉइनिंग द टू सेंटेंसेस विद द हेल्प ऑफ रिलेटिव प्रोनाउन. ओके, एंड आई होप यू विल टेक केयर ऑफ दिस थिंग कि हमें किस नाउन के साथ रिलेटिव प्रोनाउन लगाना है. ओके, द नेक्स्ट थिंग, use of pronoun. आप क्या करते हो when you join the sentences, आप personal pronoun को साथ में वैसे ही लिख देते हो दोबारा से, which is not needed, which is not required. It is not required, बेटा. Yes. So आप दोबारा से उस personal pronoun को use कर लेते हो. So the second condition is, when you join the two sentences, one of the personal pronouns should be omitted. It should be deleted. It should not remain in the sentence again. See the example. This is the cottage Reena built it. So your answer should be, this is the cottage which Reena built. But what you people do, this is the cottage which Reena built it. I mean, you again use it. So that is the wrong thing. So there are two conditions to join sentences with the help of a relative pronoun. First most condition is your antecedent and relative pronoun should be together. Relative pronoun must be followed by its antecedent. So this is the first most condition. And the second condition is one of the personal pronouns should be omitted from the sentence when you join both the sentences. If it is not omitted, that means you will yourself understand that my answer is wrong. Aapka answer wrong hoga. Fine. So only these two things that you need to take care of. Otherwise, you rest of the things you know very well. So let's do 2-3 sentences from this slide. I met a beggar. He was blind. Yes, beta. Who will give me the answer?
Ma'am, can I?
Yes, of course.
I met a beggar who was blind.
Who was blind? Okay. This is the book. I lost it. Janvi Duggal.
This is the book which I lost.
Which I lost. Yeah, that I lost. Good. So next is I am the person you sent for me. I am the person you sent for me. Yes, sorry, beta, raise your hands. No one is raising hand. 8 students have raised hand. I'm not able to see. Wait. Okay. Now it's okay. Yes, Janvi Dhingra.
I am the person whom you sent for me.
Whom you sent for? Me aap nahi lagaoge, Janvi. One of the personal pronouns should be omitted. Sent for ek phrase hai jiska matlab hota hai kisi ko bulawa bhejna. किसी को बुलाने के लिए भेजना. सो अगर आपने बोल ही दिया आई एम द पर्सन हुम, सो हुम इज रेफरिंग टू मी. आई मीन इट इज मेंट इन, इट इज यूज्ड इन प्लेस ऑफ मी. आई एम द पर्सन हुम यू सेंट फॉर. दिस इज द राइट आंसर. मी यूज नहीं करोगे. अगेन यू आर कमिटिंग द सेम मिस्टेक. ओके, नेक्स्ट सेंटेंस. ही डज हिज बेस्ट, ही शुड बी प्रेज्ड. ये थोड़ा सा ट्रिकी वन है. यस, हरनूर सिंह. नूर हरिया बच्चे. रमणीक, यू गिव मी द आंसर बच्चे.
He who does his best should be praised.
Very nice. Clap for yourself, Ramneek. This is the right answer. He who does his best, comma, should be praised. अब देखो मेरी दोनों conditions fulfill हो गई. हाँ बेटा, मैं बीच बीच में से करवा रही हूँ. Leave it. मेरी दोनों conditions fulfill हो गई. एक तो मेरा जो relative pronoun है who, that is used with the correct antecedent, और दूसरा one of the personal pronoun is omitted in this answer. So he who does his best should be praised. Okay, so this is enough for today. Now we'll just go through all the kinds of the pronouns. Yes, beta ji. So these are, a pronoun is a word that is used instead of noun. I mean, you know all these things. I need not to tell you again and again. So these are the kinds of pronoun: personal pronoun, reflexive, emphasizing, demonstrative, indefinite, distributive, possessive, and interrogative. So here I would like to talk about reflexive and emphasizing. So both the pronouns are same, means I, myself, ourselves, yourself, yourselves, himself. The words used are same, so how to identify? Beta, agar to verb ke immediately baad ye pronoun aa raha hai, so that is reflexive pronoun. Agar verb ke immediately baad is something else, kuch aur aa raha hai aur uske baad aapka ye word aa raha hai, even then it is emphasizing pronoun. Emphasizing pronoun, that it is clear from the name itself. Jab hum kisi cheez ko emphasize karne ke liye bhi use karte hain. See this example. I myself was there. Main khud wahan pe tha. You must do it yourself. अब देखिए, yourself है तो पीछे, but it is not immediately after the verb. Verb is do here, but immediately after the verb it is it, and yourself is after the it. So here yourself is emphasizing pronoun. आप ये नहीं कह सकते कि ये reflexive pronoun है. हम इस sentence को ऐसे भी बोल सकते हैं, you yourself must do it. So it hardly makes any difference. And एक और तरीका है इन दोनों में डिफ्रेंशिएट करने का. without reflexive pronouns your sentence is incomplete. जरा हाथ रख के देखिए यहाँ myself पे. I blame for it. So this is incomplete sentence. You will hurt. This is again incomplete sentence. But in case of emphasizing pronoun, if you hide emphasizing pronoun, even then your sentence is complete. I was there. You must do it. समझ लग गई. तो एम्फेसाइजिंग प्रोनाउन के बिना हमारा सेंटेंस कंप्लीट हो सकता है, बट रिफ्लेक्सिव प्रोनाउन के बिना हमारा सेंटेंस कंप्लीट नहीं हो सकता. और इमीडिएटली वर्ब के बाद आए तो दैट इज रिफ्लेक्सिव प्रोनाउन. इमीडिएटली नाउन या प्रोनाउन के बाद आए तो दैट इज एम्फेसाइजिंग प्रोनाउन. सो आई होप दिस इज क्लियर टू यू. इन डेमोन्स्ट्रेटिव प्रोनाउन्स देयर आर सम वर्ड्स लाइक दिस, दैट, दीज, दोस, सच, बट दीज शुड नॉट बी फॉलोड बाय अ नाउन. If it is followed by a noun, that means it is demonstrative adjective. See this example, this pencil is mine, this is my pencil. So, yahan noun aa gaya means this is referring to noun here. And the word which is followed by a noun, it is an adjective. But here it is not followed by a noun, it is followed by helping verb. So, this is pronoun and this is adjective. Indefinite pronoun. The words like all, some, many, few, one, etc. refer to person or thing in a general way. Ye जनरल वे में हमें रेफर करते हैं. दे डू नॉट रेफर टू एनी पर्टिकुलर पर्सन और थिंग. सो दोज आर इनडेफिनेट प्रोनाउन लाइक ऑल आर नॉट हैप्पी, मेनी आर पुअर, फ्यू कैन डू दिस. डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिव में ओनली फोर वर्ड्स आर देयर, दैट इज ईच, एवरी, ईदर, नीदर. बट अगेन दिस शुड नॉट बी फॉलोड बाय अ नाउन. ईच ऑफ यू कैन गो, ईदर ऑफ द टू पेंस विल डू. पोजेसिव जो हमारा पोजेशन बताते हैं, ये मैं आपको पहले भी बता चुकी हूँ ड्यूरिंग द चार्ट, वेल व्हेन वी डिड दैट चार्ट. Interrogative pronouns are the pronouns which are used to ask a question. The same condition in every pronoun, these should not be followed by a noun. So I hope all the kinds are clear to you, right? So I'm going to end this session here. I'm sorry, end this topic here. Now I'm going to paste attendance form. Please fill that. And I hope these topics are clear to you. Still, if you feel any problem or if you have any query, you can